Hi, this is Christine Farley, and today we're going to talk about family council meetings and family responsibilities. So, what is a family council meeting? Well, that is a meeting where you gather together as a family and you discuss your needs and your support and how you can problem solve. It also is a way that you can plan for fun things. So let's talk about what that might look like. Each individual might be asked, what are the needs that we as a family or individual parts of the family can help you with? You might gain some really good insights. Like some children may say, well, I need more quiet time, or I miss my friends. Or you might say, I need some help keeping up with the kitchen. You know, all of these kinds of things can be discussed. And then you know what some of the challenges are, and then you can problem solve together. So that's a really good way to help. Another one is ask the question, how can you help your brother, or how can you help your spouse? And so it's kind of the same kind of question, but knowing the answers and having a trusting situation in which you can freely discuss these things has great insight into what the real needs are and how things can be managed better in a home and how everybody can thrive. So I would encourage you to just call a family council meeting, and in it, I would also want to suggest this is not a time to say, you didn't do this. It could be a time instead of, I feel like this when these things don't get done. But it's not a time to point fingers. It's a time to work together as a unit. Those individual discussions can go on in another time. It's also a time where you can look and say, all right, so yes, we're under quarantine, but what fun things can we plan and what fun things can we do? And maybe even plan some things that you're going to want to do as a family or individuals when quarantine's over. But in the meantime, plan for some fun, whatever that looks like for you. And I'll be doing another video on ideas for fun. All right. Now let's go to family responsibilities. Everybody's home. Everybody needs to eat. The bathrooms get dirty. The laundry still needs to be done. So with more people at home, that means that more people can share with the workload. Now, even an 18-month-old can pick up their toys and put them in a basket or a bin. A 4 or 5-year-old, even a 3-year-old, can take silverware out of the dishwasher basket and put it in the different silver places for the silverware to go. So I think you're getting my drift on that. Is starting young is really important, but having everyone feel responsible for certain things and work together on the household needs. This is a great opportunity when everyone is home to start working on some life skills. And that would be things as basic as how to do dishes, how to cook, make sandwiches, make simple meals, even bake some yummy cookies. All of those kinds of things are also educational. I had my oldest daughter went off to college, and while she was there, one of the things that she found, her roommates, they didn't know how to clean a bathroom, they didn't know how to do laundry, and they certainly did not know how to cook. And I think that as parents, we have a responsibility to help our children to be responsible adults. And so I would encourage you, yes, it will be easier for you to do it yourself, but you will be exhausted, and your children will come out of this situation not having learned those kinds of skills. So I would encourage you to enlist the help of your family. The other thing I would talk with your spouse or your partner, and if you have one, and that is to help divide up some of the household duties. You both may be home. You both may be working from home. Your situation may be different where you're working from home more than your spouse is, and he's not working at home, but he's home. So let's communicate about how we can divide up responsibilities and work together as a whole unit, and realize that there are no a woman doesn't have to do certain things and a man doesn't have to do certain things. We can all change diapers. We can all wash laundry and get it folded and put away. We can all cook food. And if we can't, we can learn. And if there's some things that you really like to do and your spouse or significant other doesn't like to do it, hey, figure that out. But know that we can share the responsibilities. So until next time, God bless you.